So basically, there's two areas of research. We use genetic techniques to either study evolutionary relationships of bats, or then we use genetic techniques to aid in management of threatened and endangered species of bats. So one's an applied, one's a basic research question. Sure, there's a species of bat in Oklahoma. There's only about 1,100 of those individuals left in the world. About 1,000 of them occur in eastern Oklahoma. The other approximately 100 to 200 occur in western Arkansas. So they're a highly endangered, federally threatened bat that we know very little about. As far as previous genetic work, my lab's the only one who's done any work on that, and that was restricted to 5 caves in eastern Oklahoma. So we just got funding to study the genetics of the entire population, and this really has two significant implications. One is because of the distribution of these bats and they're highly endangered, how do we best manage these bats so that we don't lose them, so they don't all go extinct? And adding to that is the fact that there's a disease that's wiping out millions of bats that's moving down from the Northeast. It's already killed millions of bats in the Northeast, which has significant ecologic and economic implications. That disease has now moved into Missouri and western Oklahoma. It's jumped over eastern Oklahoma so far. But if that disease hits these bats, it could wipe out the bats completely. So part of what our study is, to aid in the management, but one possibility is that they would try and bring these bats in to captivity to prevent death. In order to do that, we have to understand much more about the genetic structure, the mating system, things like that. So my lab is generating the genetic data to try and assist Fish and Wildlife and Oklahoma Department of Wildlife Conservation in making those decisions. For this funded project, just this one bat, but we've just finished up a project, an NSF-funded project, where we work on a family of bats that's worldwide distribution. There's over 400, there's over 400 species in this one family. So we've just finished up the funding, but we continue to work on that. That's a group that I've been working on for the past 10 years. So really, my lab works on bats from all over the world.